Well, after being the Democrat nominee for almost 6 weeks, Kamala Harris finally sat down for an interview with CNN's Dana Bash alongside her running mate Tim Walz. For an interview that was pre-recorded, highly edited, and went for a total of, wait for this, 18 minutes. Wow, that really gives us an insight into what we might be getting if she becomes the President of the United States. But look, I didn't have very high expectations for this interview, but there were still a couple of moments that really shocked me. The first being that Kamala Harris has no regrets about lying to the American people.
You were a very staunch defender of President Biden's capacity to serve another 4 years. Right after the debate, you insisted that President Biden is extraordinarily strong. Given where we are now, do you have any regrets about what you told the American people?
No, not at all. Not at all.
Okay, so no regrets about repeatedly lying to the American people. Got it. What about the moment that Joe Biden dropped out of the race? Watch Kamala Harris as she tells you every unimportant little detail about her day, including what day of the week it was, something we knew, but is very vague about what actually went down.
It was a Sunday, so here, I'll give you a little too much information.
Go for it. There's no such thing, Madam Vice President.
My family was staying with us, and including my baby nieces, and we had just had pancakes and, you know, Auntie, can I have more bacon? Yes, I'll make you more bacon. And then we were gonna sit, we were sitting down to do a puzzle. And the phone rang and it was Joe Biden. And he told me what he had decided to do. And I asked him, are you sure? And he said, yes. And that's how I learned about it.
And what about the endorsement? Did you ask for it?
He was very clear that he was gonna support me.
Come on, Kamala. She even pretends that she was a little bit shocked herself. I asked, are you sure? Call me a cynic, but I'm absolutely not convinced. Now, Tim Walz was essentially asked if he lied about his military service when he claimed he carried weapons in war. And how's this for some honesty on his part? He blames his grandma for making that claim.
The idea that you said that you were in war.
Yeah.
Did you misspeak, as the campaign has said?
Yeah, I said we were talking about, in this case, this was after a school shooting, the ideas of carrying these weapons of war. And my wife, the English teacher, told me my grammar's not always correct, but it...
Okay, that's definitely it, his grammar. Now, what would Kamala do on her first day as president if she's elected?
There are a number of things. I will tell you, first and foremost, one of my highest priorities is to do what we can to support and strengthen the middle class. When I look at the aspirations, the goals, the ambitions of the American people, I think that people are ready for a new way forward. In a way that generations of Americans have been fueled by hope and by optimism.
Is it just me, or that's not very clear? But my final thoughts on this interview, because to be honest, it was pretty average, it was awkward, and it certainly was not inspiring. But I cannot handle the gaslighting, as she suggests that if she is elected, America and the rest of the world would be better off, as if she hasn't been the Vice President for the United States for the last 3.5 years.
Prices, in particular for groceries, are still too high. The American people know it, I know it. Like, we have to get a deal done. Dana, we have to get a deal done.
When it comes to the crisis in the Middle East, of course we need a deal done. So how is it that the Biden-Harris administration have not been able to achieve this?